oh, hey, sorry, I was just looking off into space and smiling. Or what is newly being called the Plandid. The Plandid is a type of Instagram photo that seems to be candid, but was totally planned out. What do they look like? Well, let's take a look at one. Beyonce.
Beyonce.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just drinking this snifter.
I just see boobs.
With my milky ass boobs.
With 3.7 million likes.
She looks so good.
3.7 million.
Look at, I love people like look at hyper imagine a cow who writes three times in a row SDV, ULTRTB. What's happening there?
Her hair looks great.
She looks great. She's such a goddess. Damn.
Mama.
Next.
I'm in love. And then this is it's definitely Reese Witherspoon with Mary Alice. Oh my God! Oh, sorry. You just said the most amazing, hilarious thing out there.
Look,
oh,
I believe that Reese lives like this. Yeah. So I actually believe that most of her moments are just her laughing and smiling and having a good day.
So, what do you think about the Plandid thoughts? Five words or less.
Guilty sometimes.
Plandids all day, every day.
You piece of garbage.
They work, dude. They work.
Those are the best pictures. I tell people all the time. We did this yesterday here in the studio. Let's take a picture of all of us laughing together.
I didn't say that. I take full responsibility for it. What did I do during that?
It looked really good. It was a good picture. They work. Like I don't see. I mean, I get the authenticity of capturing a moment that actually happens. But when you don't have the luxury of capturing that moment organically, you gotta resort to other measures, and that's where you inject Plandids. And some of the best pictures I've ever liked on Instagram probably were fake, but they're beautiful, they're stunning, they work.
So some people are saying that Plandid photos are humble brags in a visual form, mm-hmm. in the sense that you're just bragging about your life, but you're not saying, you're not really saying anything about it. It's just like, look, yachts, what? Yachts, me? And then another thing that they said too is that the way to counteract the humble brag and the icky feeling of like FOMO that people see when they see a humble brag, because we're all really self-involved, is to counteract that with a caption that is self-deprecating to the tune of something along the lines of laughing, but I have horrible gas. I don't know how to write. I really am bad at writing captions, so I write paragraphs on everything.
Hashtag
just farted. Which maybe smile, because that's a release of pressure, and maybe that would make you feel better. But what I'm saying is
a dip take. You should do one side is before you farted, and the other side is after.
So do you guys agree with what they say about Plandid photos, that it's you have to sort of cut it with a self-deprecating comment, and that they are humble brags in the photo?
Because the whole point is you want to come off as being less conceited. And you actually are, and you're actually way more conceited because you planned this whole thing.
Well, because you think you look good in that photo, and there isn't anything wrong with thinking that you look good in a photo. It can be a nice confidence booster.
Totally,
now and again.
Totally. I would rather you just keep it real. Listen, I think it's more ridiculous when people are like, "I'm with Beyonce, haha, my hair is out of place." Like, no, if you look fierce, you look fierce. Like, own it. It's okay. We are all on Instagram. Maybe I'm an asshole. Maybe this is my lament that I'm a douchebag. You know, I don't care. If you are proud about how you look, celebrate that. But when people are like, "Oh, I want to be self-deprecating," that makes me more mad. Seems like they want more attention.
I get it, man. You're layering. You just painted one layer of inauthenticity and covered it with like a compensatory layer of neurosis.
It's like, look, you think you look hot that day? You probably do, good for you. You probably look the same tomorrow, so live it up while you can.
The question on everyone's mind is, have we done Plandids? Here are the answers in no particular order. First photo. Yes.
No, that's a selfie. You knew, like that's obviously you knew you were taking the photo. It's not staged at all.
This is a 100% Plandid, like
Didn't he?
What?
But like,
I know, look at the composition, Mickey's right there.
I did it that way. That is a ridiculous smile.
That's a great picture, Brett.
That is not really good. Genuine. Thank you. That is not a genuine. That's not what I look like when I'm happy.
Yeah, but it's a selfie.
That's what I look like when my hair has grown all the way down my neck. Look
at
that. Oh,
wow. I didn't even notice that. But listen,
Holy shit.
Yeah.
It's like you have a mask.
It looks like
Chewbacca.
It looks like, much like Achilles, I was dipped in the river Styx.
You have a cheek beard, too. It's like way up
here. Look at the hole.
Yeah, on your neck.
Yeah.
What's happening?
I don't know. Also, what I would like to say is that there's no assumption that you didn't take that photo, so I don't think it can be a Plandid. No one assumed that you can't take a candid selfie.
Unlike this, the next photo, Grace, we gotta have
You're so naive. It's adorable.
Yeah, that's total Plandid.
Total Plandid.
For sure.
But it's a great picture,
but
though.
Like three
Grace,
times as many
picture.
Likes as my Plandid.
Look how fresh and jubilant.
Well, here's I will explain this photo.
You have to pee.
No, well, maybe. I kind of always.
Did you say our shucks when you were
off
done?
To the side.
No, but I had just gotten this haircut that I really liked, and I was the truth of this was I got in this haircut, I really liked it, but then right after I got the haircut, I was in Sioux Falls for a comedy festival by myself in a hotel room, and no one would there were no flattering photos there, so I was like, oh, look at this, I want to show off my haircut. This is a good photo that I had before when I used to take photos with Haas, and so I post it, and I feel very good about this.
As you should.
Although I would question the choice of bandana necklace. I don't know if I would do that.
Here's what it is to me. Okay, so let's look at the next one.
Oh, that's a good one.
Is that
that's
good?
I would say this is the most. This person is a goddamn model. Like fucking so good at
it's
modeling.
It's a good jawline.
Like his jawline angles, composition,
angles.
Location.
You're very symmetrical, even when your head is off to the side.
Like this. As opposed to Grace, not many kind people of just pull looking that off.
Yeah.
What's he thinking?
I'm thinking.
There's something deep going on behind the eyes.
There's nothing deep going on.
If I had to rank them, I'd be like, mine, biggest idiot of the three. Grace, adorbs. Jason, damn. How does he do it? Kind of stuff. Mm.
Okay, so I don't have any. Apparently I don't have any.
And Amir does not.
But I want to throw another hat
before,
to the ring.
Before you throw your hat into the ring. Just some applause for Amir.
You're not vapid, shallow, or vacuous.
That's absolutely not true. I'm
all of those. Throw another hat.
Oh!
Our own associate producer,
Sophie.
Is the queen.
No! You got to do the one at Disneyland. The one at Jackson Square.
Sophie is killing it. Honestly, Sophie has the best Instagram.
We're gonna have to put.
She does. We have to put these ones.
Yeah, Jackson Square was great though. It'll get bigger, but out of focus.
Sophie is the queen.
So I don't think we should be shaming. shaming people for their awesome pictures.
No, not at all. Right now we're having a competition who has the best.
Sorry, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Here's when to shame them. Is A, when you're feeling bad about yourself, it's totally healthy to shame other people. That's not true. But it is okay to shame when there is an inauthenticity. That's the problem. It's the inauthenticity. This person hits it on the head. Now, that's not to say that I think one of the most inauthentic photos you can take is the conventional photo, where everyone's like, sit, come in here, Grace, into my shot.
Now look away.
Look another way. Or over there, like
it's so much better as soon as you guys did that.
Yeah,
that's
a great picture.
Look at your cheek beard.
I shaved my neck beard today.
Hey, here's a question for the panel. Is it possible that we're overthinking how people post to Instagram?
Absolutely.
No.
Yes, we are.
So since when do people overthink social media?
I think the people
so we
who
do. Grace went on down a rabbit hole of Dr. Deep. Abs.
Ah! Sorry, the
I'm just saying it's a very real discussion.
Yes.
What do you think?
I think that the real culprit and the real bad person is a person who can take Plandids and make it look like they're being not taking a Plandid, but secretly they're like, yes, I'm succeeding at duping all of you.
Yeah.
Guilty.
You do that. Mm-hmm.
It's definitely not as bad as the camping photos we did a few weeks back. Remember the fake camping photos?
Sure. Oh, I thought you were throwing shade at me. I was like, yeah, motherfucker, I go camping.
But even those are great, you don't have a monopoly on camping.
I don't even remember those.
Where the people were saying that they're camping places that they're not, like Central Park.
It was, you didn't sleep there.
You were totally there.
It was you didn't sleep there.
Yeah, that's great.
That's funny.
I think if you just appreciate the picture, like I love scrolling through people's Instagram and seeing a great pic or seeing different types of pics, different filters and stuff, because there is some creativity. Having a really awesome Instagram takes work.
Yeah.
It takes creativity and it takes time to curate and make sure that they're, like, I have a friend who will post a picture, and if it doesn't, if the theme of the last four pictures he's posted isn't in line with this picture, he'll delete it because he wants his Instagram to be cohesive. And he's gotten sponsorships from it. It's been very lucrative for him because people have really taken to the creativity behind his Instagram. So I think if you're good at it, do it. You know, it's like YouTube videos.
They do well.
I think the intentions matter at the end of the day, and people, we naturally were just striving to make the things look as best as they can.
I don't like to feel like I've been manipulated by someone.
Yeah,
I hate it. And I see it all the time where a lot of folks online are getting manipulated
and
by these kinds
of
decisions.
And it fucks with people's mental and their perceptions.
In that, definitely. In and that just this you're putting out there that it's a this just kind of happened, and it didn't. And that's not nice to do to people, especially in a world where a lot of folks are looking for that. I mean, this article, I don't know what it's on, Elite Daily, I don't know if they coined the term or whatever, but it's spot on when you're looking for authenticity. And a lot of what folks are looking for is people to be honest with them. The format that a lot of people use is the selfie or talking straight to camera from their house if they're doing like a vlog style video on YouTube. It's that there's no one here but us. And if this is a lie, then that sucks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's what I think.
Yeah, you're right about the connection. But final thought, I think that but it's not that serious though. You know what I'm saying? Like social media, it's not that serious. And people, you know, there's a conversation we had about the effects of social media on young people and the youth. And I think that if the conversation goes to, this is just for shits and giggles, entertainment. It's like reading your horoscope. They say this is just for entertainment value. It's not really going to happen. Same thing with social media. You have to take it with a grain of salt.
Right, but then there's also those things that seem like medicines, but it's like this is not approved by the FDA for anything. It should not be used to diagnose, to cure, or prevent any disease. It's like, well, then what the hell are we doing here?
TBH, this is just chalk.
Yeah, you know, honestly, it might kill you. We don't know. We wouldn't need that stuff.